In today's tutorial, I want to show you how to do groundwater potential zone mapping using remote sensing and GIS. In doing this, there are a few things we need to take note of. And number one, if you are doing groundwater potential analysis in GIS, you have to read about your study area, especially review literatures to know the important factors that are relevant to your study area, because no two study areas are the same. Then number two, know the influence of each factor as related to your study area. Then number three, you must also know the type of terrain you are working on, whether it is sedimentary terrain or crystalline terrain, or is even the mixture of sedimentary and crystalline terrain, because some factors that are relevant in crystalline terrain may not be relevant in sedimentary terrain. So you need to know this about your study area before running groundwater potential mapping. So, and this you can achieve by reading literatures and previous work that has been done on the subject matter as related to your study area. So let's go to the analysis. Now in ArcGIS, I have my five factors that I want to consider in this analysis. I have prepared my thematic map for lineaments, drainage density, slope, rainfall, and geology. So how to prepare these individual factors or thematic map? I've done them previously, and check the description box, you'll see those videos there. So now the first thing to do after you have prepared your thematic map is to weigh them using analytic hierarchy process. So let's go, this is the analytic hierarchy process software. So here you have to bring in your factors or criteria and weigh them. So here I have five criteria. So here I will input five. Then number of participants, one. Then here in this table, that is sheet one under summary. In this table, you enter all your criterion. So the criteria one is lineament density. The second criteria is drainage density. The third criterion is slope. The next one is rainfall. And finally, we have geology. So we have these five criterion that we want to use. After you have inputted your criterion like this, you move to the next sheet. Then you'll see your criteria here, and you have to do pairwise comparison of this criterion. Now, another thing you need to note is that for you to know the weight or the influence of each of these factors on the subject matter, groundwater potential, you must read about your study area and know the nature of these factors in your study area for you to be able to assign weights and also to do the pairwise comparison. So now to do the pairwise comparison, you come to this table and compare the criteria in column A here with the ones in column B here. So here, click on this drop down here, choose A, which means lineament density. Now if you come down, you will see the definition of those numbers: 1 mean equal importance, 3 mean moderate importance, and so on. So we must also study this to understand. Then when you come here, you want to compare the criterion in column A to column B. So choose, click here and choose this one, which means A, that is lineament density, how important it is compared to this one. So here, equal importance, this one slope is 2. Compare it with rainfall, 3. compare it with geology, one. So how you assign this depends on your study area and the factors you are considering. So you have to read extensively to know how to do the pairwise comparison of these factors. So now you move to compare drainage density with other criteria. Click here. A, that is drainage density, how important it is compared to this. 2, one, equal importance. Then compare slope with these ones. Slope compared to rainfall, 2. Slope compared to geology, 2. Then rainfall compared to geology, rainfall to geology, 2. Then after such comparison, you see it will assign weights to, like, lineament. This is the you see the weights, and also more importantly, you have to look at the consistency ratio. If it is more than 10%, it means it's not consistent. You have to do the pairwise comparison again. If it is more than 10%, now here we got 8%. Then come back to the summary page. If you come back to the summary page, you can see the weights assigned to each of the factors. And then if you scroll down, you can see the pairwise comparison matrix here, which you can just highlight and copy and attach it to your work. So here you can see the weights and you can see the consistency ratio. So now it is time to copy these values. Copy it somewhere, and this one that points something can round it up or round down because the GIS will not take decimal. So let's go to GIS now, write these figures down. Then here you want to do the groundwater potential mapping or analysis using weighted sum. So to do that, come to ArcToolbox, come to spatial analysis tool, then scroll down and come to overlay. Then we have different technique of doing this multi-criteria analysis. So the technique we want to use is weighted sum. Of course, you can use weighted overlay. We have a lot of technique here. So today we are using weighted sum. In the subsequent video, we may consider other technique to see how they work. So double click to open the weighted sum table. Just highlight all your criteria and move them here. Now when you move them, you see the field you are using value and you see weights here. This is where you input the weights you got in AHP. So you input it here. So we lineament density, I have copied it somewhere, is 27%. Drainage density 24%. Slope 19%. And rainfall 14%. Then geology 16%. So the total must be 100%. Now one of the downside of weighted sum is that weighted sum technique does not give us room for intra-criteria evaluations. So it only gives us the room for inter-criteria evaluation. You can't do intra-criteria, unlike a weighted overlay. However, it's also a good technique. So now after you have input your criteria here and you have assigned the weights which you got from analytical hierarchy process pairwise comparison, click here to navigate to your folder and name it, let's say, groundwater potential map. Then click on save. Then click on OK. So the analysis is running. It will create our groundwater potential zones. Yes, it's done. The weighted sum is done. So let me close this. Then right click and come to properties. Then you see the number of classes. If you want to change the number of classes, you can do that, and you can even change the color. Then you can format the label, let's say to one decimal place. Click on OK and click on OK. Yes, this is our groundwater potential map, and of course you can even change the color here as theme fits. Yes, this is the groundwater potential map. What you can do, you can normalize the map, or you can reclassify depending on your needs. Or if you want it just to be like this, you can now take your map to layout and add your map elements. This is how to do groundwater potential mapping using weighted sum technique in ArcMap. I hope this tutorial is helpful to someone. Please like this video and subscribe.